Marsha Doiron and Jordi Segers. Masters of Business and numerous years working in the tourism industry, including owning her own shop, Cottage Life Boutique, our next star helps people discover their untapped potential with her consulting firm, Level Up. She's always looking for a new challenge. Introducing Marsha Doiron. Being up to try any dance style at least once, Jordi Segers has a love for dance styles including Lindy Hop and Charleston. You can find him dancing at Downstreet Dance Studio, pole dancing at Aerial Warehouse, playing the ukulele, or out in the wilderness taking wildlife photography.
Hi, my name is Marsha Doiron, and I am the star this evening. I'm doing this as a tribute to my dad. He passed away 6 years ago of Parkinson's disease, and he had it for like 12 years, and it was quite a journey to kind of see that all unfold. And I'm just doing this as a tribute to him.
I'm Jordi Segers. I suppose that makes me the pro then. I'm a biologist by night, I guess, because I'm a bat biologist, so I'm a bat biologist by night and a dancer by day, I suppose. I do Lindy Hop and Charleston, and that's what we're going to show tonight.
I'm a serial entrepreneur, I guess. My husband and I own a series of businesses. We own a resident care home in New Brunswick. We own a campground in New Brunswick. I own a shop here, and I'm a consultant.
And why did you decide you wanted to do this?
Well, I mean, dancing is my passion, and sharing dance with others is just the best thing in the world. And just getting the opportunity to work with someone one-on-one and training them from the ground up and seeing them from saying, oh, I don't have any coordination, to just dancing like a pro is very fulfilling.
What kind of student is she?
Marsha is very determined and very driven. So whenever I introduce something new, like, oh, let's try this, and it was a really cool thing, but it was very challenging, and I'm like, we don't have to do this. She's like, we do. We're gonna do this. And yeah, so that's what I got. Whatever I introduce, I had to be careful to introduce things to, because I knew that we were gonna go through with whatever I threw at her.
Yeah. So what has it been like for you, this all this being a student?
Oh my goodness, this journey has been, it's exceeded my expectations, because I went into it blindly. Like as Jordi said, I have no coordination at all, and I wanted to do something that was totally uncomfortable, and I wanted to do something that I suck at and laugh at myself, and we laughed at both of us quite a bit, and it's been truly amazing. He's very patient with this student. I'm a very challenging student, but it's been amazing, like that I want to keep dancing.
What kind of student was she?
Well, anything that you just said doesn't resonate with me. It was easy to teach her. Like there are obviously challenges, and some things are harder than others, and it depends on who you're teaching. But like I said, she was just so driven that whatever I threw at her, she's like, we're gonna make this work.
What do I want to say to my competition? Just that it was a pleasure being in this, sharing the same stage with everybody else. It's been an honor being part of this, and good luck to everybody.
I've seen him in the dress rehearsals, and it's just, everybody looks amazing. I already had some tears in my eyes earlier today, and probably will again later tonight, just seeing these amazing stars and pros show off what they've been working on so hard. So good luck to everyone, and I'm already proud of everyone.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
I'm cool, but I wanna go. I'm walking slower so everyone can catch your breath. There you go.
Thanks.
Wow, that was wonderful. What a great flip.
She nailed it.
She nailed it. She did very well. That's awesome. So what's it like dancing with Jordi?
Oh my gosh, this is the most patient man besides my husband. Very, very challenging student he had. We had a lot of coaching to get to that little number that we had. But no, he was so fun.
Oh, you look to be having a lot of fun.
So fun,
so
yes.
That's great.
Yes.
And what inspired you to be up here dancing with the stars?
This was primarily a tribute to my dad. My dad passed away about 6 years ago of Parkinson's, and it was a very long journey. And while we didn't utilize the services of hospice, we would have loved to been able to do so. And this whole journey was something that I wanted to do to get uncomfortable. I turned 50 in 2020, and I wanted to get uncomfortable. I wanted to do something amazing and contribute back to the community.
Wow, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. So I'm gonna pass you over to the judges. Don't leave yet, don't leave yet. Julia.
Bravo, Marsha, for taking on new things and new challenges. It's so uplifting. I felt like getting up there and dancing with you. The energy was...
Yes.
Well, I was chair dancing, but I love the opening with the ukuleles. Like, right away, it puts a smile on your face and all the new steps that you learned and, of course, the fabulous ending. So thank you so much for that. It was super fun.